y'all. It's been a minute. This is my yoga mic. I use this for my yoga classes, but the quality of it is so good. I picked up some sunflowers, and I'm not sure if I want to plant them in one of the garden beds or if I want to repot them and leave them out here for fall. And I also recently built a hammock, which I've logged. Moving it back here, so I'm gonna grab the weed whacker and just, you know, do a little bit of the grass here underneath. Okay, my aunt from BC was just visiting. She got one for me and my sister. This is my farmer's outfit of the day. I'm doing lawn work like an adult. My tan on tan on darker tan. It's weird, I think about living in Toronto often. Like, I feel like I'm connecting back to, it was honestly 10 years ago, it was grade 11. I used to like wear cowgirl boots all the time. It's weird to see the parallels in your life as you go on. I don't identify with the city girl version of me anymore, which is a new thing, just new, which I guess is a good segue because I recently went back to Toronto.
A fun little mini road trip we're going on today.
So when she was down in Toronto, and then also my friend Maria, who was plant sitting my plants for almost a year. So thank you to Maria for keeping my plants alive, including my lucky plant. This one was hanging in the window of my bedroom. And then, oh my Lord, in here, the one that was in the corner, look at how long it is. And then also how much this one's grown. Oh man, I don't even remember exactly where I was going with that, but just it's interesting to see the parallels that play out in your life and the patterns that play out in your life. And then I need to take a bigger breath. To just accept that you are where you're meant to be. Anyway, let's do some yard work. Let's go. Welcome to my whip. Oh,
how you doing?
I have some drone footage somewhere of me driving this whip when I first got her. Slice her in here. He's a mood. I don't know, I haven't really named it. I feel like maybe we should do that now. Why do I want to call her Betty? It's very folklore. I lived on a farm with my farmer man and, you know, we had a horse. Her name would be Betty. Or maybe my name would be Betty, I don't know. I like that name. That makes me want to listen to folklore, which is exactly what I'm gonna do. Starting with Betty, now I feel it. If 10 years ago me knew this would be 10 years from then me, riding my tractor, I would, oh, that was not going backwards, hold up. She would cry. I swear this is not my first time. Hold up. I don't know anything, but I know I miss you. I swear I've ridden this a lot. Always playing from the far side of the gym. Ooh, this is gonna be fun. I was no that can't be good. I saw you dance with him. You heard the rumors from Ines. You can't believe a word she says most times, but this time it was true. The worst thing that I ever did was what I did to you. See him? Isn't he cute? Fuck myself, or lead me to the garden. In the garden, would you trust me if I told you it was just a summer thing? I'm only 17. I don't know anything, but I know I miss you. This is my little patio. This will be the one that I'll be doing a little DIY on with you guys. I want to build a little bar table out here for some coffee or a moment like right now where I was just having some epiphanies and I wanted to journal. I have some wood in the garage. I just want to quite literally put two posts side by side, hammer them in, paint the whole thing white again, and then just get some stools to sit underneath, maybe like a plant or two over here. Find a way to bring the string lights up a little higher. I think eventually as well, I would get a little screen for the door so that I could leave it open. So lately I've got back into bullet journaling. My mind has been all over the place, and bullet journaling is sweet because you can kind of map out wherever your brain goes. Reading this book, Larissa and I are actually reading it together. She got me onto it. It's called Anatomy of the Spirit by Kalyn or Miss. It's a deep book. Like, it's about energy healing. And even today was so peaceful. And I really enjoy my time alone because I don't feel like I'm invading on anybody. I'm really sensitive to certain things, and I used to think I was kind of crazy for it. I was just reading some of the things that she was talking about and learning how to use that on yourself, reading about energy fields, and it got me just thinking. Some thoughts were flowing and I wanted to kind of somewhere write them down. Just like write down notes from the books I'm reading, things that happened that day, what I'm feeling, the weather, where the moon's at, like anything that feels relevant for the day. I'll just take note. Betty, I'm here on your doorstep, and I planned it out for weeks now, but it's finally sinking in. Betty, right now is the last time I can dream about what happens when you see my face again. So I'm just starting out my computer gist, checking some things off the list. I didn't do a card reading. Should I do a card reading? No, if I have to ask the question. Oh boy, I keep on catching myself lately needing to do that just to like take a deep breath. I feel like I just keep on having life chats after life chats, especially now that the mic is on me. I feel like I can do B-roll and talk at the same time. This is such an elevated step we just took in the vlog world. I think lately, and I'm not even sure when it started, but I would just, maybe spring when I posted that vlog where I was so anxious because I felt like globally, I didn't understand really what was going on, and I felt like I was losing the sense of control. My intuition was all out of whack, and I was getting all of these bad signs, this bad energy, this intuitive hit of like, something's wrong, something's wrong. I've been trying to just lean into what I feel rather than attack what I feel. Like, instead of being like, you're so silly, nothing's wrong, why are you feeling this way? I think our bodies actually are really intelligent, and the way that our bodies communicate with our brains, so certain images popping into your mind at a certain time or certain things connecting for you, that happens for reasons. We generate these waves of energy, and it's just through our cells living that generates that energy. And everything has this like energy coating to it. One of the strongest negative, and I want to fix the word negative already. I don't want to say it's necessarily negative because we were born with fear for a reason. The problem with working with that energy of fear is that nothing you do out of that state will ever make sense. Like, it's not going to be in alignment. It's not going to feel like you're choosing based on your values or your morals, because when you come from a place of fear, you're just trying to survive. Now I've gotten to a place where I've realized that I can't keep operating from a place of fear. When I come from a place of peace, when I follow my heart, when I trust my gut, I've never been led wrong this far in my life, ever. Started seeing what was causing me fear. I sought out answers, trying to live in a state of like peace, peaceful empowerment. It's not always roses and daisies. I mean, there's still things that happen, and all of a sudden I'm like, I can't breathe, slowing down, giving myself a chance to ask questions, giving myself a chance to not have to move so quickly. That has been so huge. Just a little segue. I love vlogging with this microphone. So I'm starting editing the vlog. What day is it? And I'm realizing my footage starts July 16th. So I showed up at your party. Yeah, I showed up at your party. Vlogging over a month. I'm so sorry, guys. I just couldn't. I wasn't sure what I wanted to come on here and say, you know? Okay, update. It's been a few hours. So it's now 8:30. I have edited the vlog up until this point. Started going all out with all the Betty edits, and then I was just like, screw it. And then I started with Spectrum by Andrew Bell at the beginning. Only was released recently. Can't wait for the rest of his album. I'm not gonna monetize this vlog. Did not get all the things done. I did get the vlog edited, which is important. It's been a while since I've uploaded a vlog. Maybe film a gaming video before the night's up. It's like going on 9, but if I can get ready by 9, maybe I can film another game. I just wanted to say thanks for tuning in. Content like this is important right now. Just content where you can tune in and then kind of tune back out. But I think that there's also a lot going on in the world, and I sometimes feel a little selfish uploading what I'm doing with my life on the day-to-day. It's probably a little bit better. Little tongues and lighting, my neon party going on behind me here. Watching back this vlog, even hearing my voice and hearing the really deep, like raspy tone to it, I think our bodies hold a lot of energy, and I think our throat, why am I nervous laughing? I'm so concerned someone's gonna be like, what is she saying? Who cares? The throat chakra is the chakra of listening, and it's the chakra of speaking your truth. And I know we already talked about fear, but let's close this on out with, take the deep breaths if you need them, but you're also allowed to feel peace. You're allowed to have a giggle. You're allowed to like enjoy your day. I know things are really intense right now. This was a chatty vlog with this new microphone we got here. I'm all over the place. My camera keeps dying. I really need to wrap this up, but we're in this wild ride together, you know, the 2020s, man, we're all riding this train. So buckle up. Stay safe, and I'll talk to you guys in my next vlog. Good night.